Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'll keep. Land grant. Here's my hand.
Okay.
Resolves.
Seems like a good hand.
Yeah, this is, I mean, assuming you don't have a counterspell here, this is lethal. Well, it's in here somewhere. It's a taiga.
Is that your only land?
That's my only land, yep. So, Charbelcher for about 52, 51 coming up.
Do you need to land it?
I don't think so.
Well, I guess you don't want to run into it.
I do want to deck thin when I manamorphose. I don't want to run into it, that's true. And also, if you counter here, it's one less. It gives me a card to work with.
I don't
with
have the counter spell. Concede.
Okay. Well, just to.
Unless you want to.
I do want to do it for the audience, if you don't mind, just really quickly. So, play Lotus Petal and Lion's Eye Diamond. Rite of Flame makes 2 mana. Rite of Flame makes 4 mana, because it gives you an extra for each in the yard already. So with 4 mana out, I could just, from here, I could play the Charbelcher and then pop the Lion's Eye Diamond for the lethal. I do want to see what my extra card would have been. We'll make it, say, red-green. It's a timber wall. Why not? Sure. You know, play the Charbelcher, pop Lion's Eye Diamond, boom. And then no lands. So, yay! Charbelcher, interactive magic! Yay! Alright, take 2. Now, you'll be on the play?
Mm-hmm.
Alright.
Definitely.
Yes, seems good. Get out our spell pierces and stifles and whatever. Oh, I don't think stifle's in there. Maybe. Could be wrong.
I'll keep.
I'll keep as well.
Brainstorm.
Resolves.
Go ahead.
All right. There's no way that this works. I mean, you have to have something, I'm sure. Alright, the way to do it that doesn't involve you, that would be ideal. Let's see, could go. One, two, three, five. Okay, but I end up with the same result either way, ultimately. Alright. Chromox, imprint it with a desperate ritual. That's if it resolves.
Yeah.
Okay. Imprint it with a desperate ritual. Forgot that wasn't part of the casting cost. Play a Lion's Eye Diamond.
Mm-hmm.
Double Spirit Guide.
Mm-hmm.
Seething Song.
Yep.
Checking sideboard. make sure this works. Not that part of the sideboard. Oh my god, Jay. See, there's a real sideboard and there's a wishboard. So... oh, if only I could do both at once. So, 5 men in the pool. 3, 6... I can do it. Okay. I'm gonna go for it. I'll spend 2 mana on Burning Wish, hold it, pop Lion's Eye Diamond for blue. Like, holding priority, pop it for blue. Resolves?
Burning Wish, you can get a sorcery.
Sorcery.
A sorcery. I'll force will.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know where you can get it, but maybe it can work around a counterspell.
Yeah, usually Empty the Warrens is the one that will. And then, pass turn, and I'm just gonna dirtle for a while.
I just will just show my life total now.
Fair enough.
Ancient Tomb. Lotus Petal.
Yep.
Pass turn.
Pass turn. I have a feeling we're going to a game 3.
Intuition.
Oh. Yeah. You're given so many choices when you play this card. Is the card signed or the sleeve?
The card.
Okay. I will give you the pre-release promo. And then, yay, triggers. Yeah. Ay, ay, ay. Such is the joy of playing this deck, I suppose.
This also goes in here.
Oh, you shuffle intuition in after? Oh, yeah, it's in the graveyard. That's right. My bad. It's in the graveyard when it resolves. Go! Oh.
Show and tell.
Yeah, okay. What did you bring to class? I brought an Elvish Spirit Guide.
Alright, game?
Yeah, that's game. Empty the Warrens. Oh boy. Alright, my friend, best to ya. I would like to be on the play. Can't let you get out that turn one brainstorm or hold up spell pierce or anything. Just have to hope to have it. Ooh. Ooh, okay. No. I think.
No? Morgan?
I think so. There's a sideboard card in here, and not a single one in my hand will let me play it. So I think I have to. Plus, it doesn't have a win condition. It has a lot of ramp, but no win condition. So that's another issue with it, unfortunately. Just didn't get the right color mana. No, petals.
Mulligans can't be good for that deck.
No, very much not.
I'm keeping.
You see your life slowly fade away. Alright, my friend. Yeah, I'm not sure my life total matters, but then I'm also not sure that yours does. Oh, of course it does for some win cons. Let's see what 6 and a scry gives me. Oh, this is so much worse. I can't go down. I have to keep. Shove that to the bottom. Actually, it doesn't matter whether I kept that or not, because we are starting off with a land grant. Reveal 2 Elvish Spirit Guides, a Ritual, a Chrome Mox, and a Burning Wish. Oh, yeah. Flip that around while I go in. And it resolves?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that resolves.
Okay. I'm assuming we don't We don't hit the early spells like this. Yeah. Sometimes it's right too if you think they're going off with Empty the Warrens, because if you try to, other than Flusterstorm and Mindbreak Trap, you can't really counter Empty the Warrens.
Mm-hmm.
But if you think they're going off with Charbelcher, yeah, you hit the Charbelcher and that's it. I will say, since it's not showing up in this hand, I had a Xanthid Swarm in my last hand.
But you couldn't play it?
I couldn't play it. No green mana. Yep. That's one of the real sideboard cards. Alright. So, from here, I can go... I actually can't get enough. Not yet.
Not enough for empty?
Not enough for Burning Wish empty. If this were an Empty the Warrens, I'd be fine. But...
Empty for six.
Yeah, so it could be... let's see. One, these aren't spells. Two, three, four, five. Oh, yeah, but the Chrome Box doesn't work unless I have another card anyway. So this is just not a grand hand. Let me check my sideboard one more time just to make sure I don't have something.
So shouldn't you wait to cast Land Grant then?
Well, I would like to get the thinning so I'm more likely to find a real card instead of a Taiga later. But yeah, if I'm going for the Storm Kill, but then there's another thing I could do with Burning Wish that doesn't involve Storm that I was trying to cast on you earlier.
Well, no spoilers.
No spoilers yet. Pass turn. Might be better to play the Mox there. I'm actually not sure. Yeah, I don't just win off Charbelcher and Empty in this match.
Pass turn.
Uh-oh. Like that. Chrome Mox?
Mm-hmm.
Land Grant? Let's see. Five mana... Still not enough. Pass turn. It's not looking good.
Ancient Tomb.
Uh-oh.
Your turn.
Okay. So I can go off this turn. I think I'm going to get crushed regardless, so we'll go for it while you have fewer cards. Lion's Eye Diamond?
Mm-hmm.
What's the minimum number I need to go off here? Three, four, two... I pop it, and then I have to choose your own adventure. If I do it that way. Okay. So, two green in the pool. Pyretic Ritual?
Mm-hmm.
Alright. So that puts me up to three red and a green. Three red and two green. Go to one red and two red and a green, I mean to say. And then hold priority, I'm assuming, yeah. It doesn't...
I guess I should wait till you do the Lion's Eye Diamond, but...
Yeah.
There's no guarantee that you'll do it.
And then I pass turn. Yep.
Intuition. That's a thing.
Uh-oh. I'll tell you, I sided out all of my cantrips, just extra, they're fluff cards, and they can be replaced with anti-counter magic. It makes the combo less consistent, but also more resilient. Hi, Grizzlebrand. Yeah.
Your turn.
Oh. Oh. Your turn.
Your turn.
Play a Xanted Swarm.
Mm-hmm.
Pass turn. Little late, buddy. Pyroblast. Counterspell?
Play Daze.
Daze. Okay. Yeah. Ponder resolves. It's an odd spot to do it, but he has sneak attack potentially.
I haven't played a land this turn, right?
I think that you played the Volcanic last turn, okay. So I think you're good. Yikes. Yikes. Yeah, I'm not exactly rocking Wasteland. Beep. Show and tell. What did you bring to class? I didn't bring anything. I left it at home.
I'll draw 7.
Alright. I was that kid that they said we were doing show and tell, and I didn't bring anything, so I went outside and got some bugs and brought them in. Hmm. That was apparently it.
Alright, discard 2 lands. Pass turn.
Alright.
That'll keep your Xanted Swarm from attacking.
Yeah. Pass turn.
Sneak attack.
Yikes.
Okay. Show me Big Daddy Imrakul. Big Mama. In response, Pyretic Ritual, good game.
Good game.
Good games. Okay. So the sideboard for me was... really quickly. It was Xanted Swarms and Pyroblast 4 and 3, I believe. Maybe it was 3 and 4.
So what was it that you could have gotten instead of Empty the Worms?
That's a good question. Let me pull that up just a quick sec. So it was 4 Xanted Swarms, 3 Pyroblast. So alternatively, there's a blue sorcery called Telamon Performance. Make you reveal cards from your deck until you hit a creature. All the non-creatures go in the yard, and I get the creature. So you can use this on creatureless decks to make them mill themselves out, or a deck like Show and Tell or Reanimator to take their creature. So I get an Imrakul in this case. Or a Grizzlebrand.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, and if I get a Grizzlebrand, that can often just be game right there. I can draw 7, okay. And then 7 is a good hand here. So Telamon Performance is the other one I could have used.
It's pretty sweet.
I think so. It's obviously a lot faster to win with than Empty the Warren, so that was my preference in the match. If you let the Burning Wish resolve... I would assume you would not let the Telamon Performance resolve as well, and part of the advantage to Empty the Warrants is it beats counter magic a bit.
Mm-hmm.
So that isn't really a thing anymore. Other win cons, there's one Empty the Warrant in the sideboard, different art so that I can remember it, make sure it stays in the sideboard. And if I can't quite kill with Empty the Warrants that turn, there's a Goblin War Strike. Just one.
Yeah, seems a little unnecessary.
Sometimes it actually does matter if I need to kill the opponent that turn. Like, for example, if you have an Empty the Warrens naturally, not from Burning Wish, you know, on the second turn after you've dealt some damage, you can War Strike to finish them.
I see.
Or if you get enough Storm that you can make 20 anyway, War Strike. Diminishing Returns, so that I can just redraw. It's my Time Twister.
Mm-hmm.
Draw 7 again to try to go off if I couldn't quite make it. Pyroclasm for little creatures, Reverent Silence for enchantments, Shattering Spree for artifacts, Trash for treasure to get Charbelcher back from the yard. Second artifact, also known as Chrome Mox or Lotus Petal. You need to go to town from there. And then everything else is just anti-counter magic.